Hello my crafty friends and welcome to a fun video hop. Today we are celebrating the latest release by Altenew and I'm super excited to be a part of a video hop where you will be able to see all the products in action, you will find lots of inspiration and also win prizes. So make sure to hop along with us, leave comments below the videos here on YouTube for a chance to win. So for my card today I'm going to play with a new product which is called Bitterroot Flower. There are matching stencils and dies. And the dies not only cut out the main flower bouquet, but they also give you more options such as separate flowers to layer on top. There are 3 stencils in the set and you simply follow the layering guide at the back of the packaging. Using layering stencils is quicker than using layering stamps because they are super easy to align one on top of the other and you get amazing results in no time. Now here I am going to first cut out the outline of the bouquet so I know exactly where I'm going to ink up with the stencils. It really makes life easier this way. And then since I will have my die cutting machine out, I'm going to do embossing as well. For that I'm using a 3D embossing folder from a previous release by Altenew, one of my favorites for sure. It is called Modern Squares 3D and I absolutely love the versatility of this design, makes the perfect background. So I did embossing with my Spellbinders Platinum machine, just use the main platform, your sandwich, the embossing folder and the paper inside and then on top one cutting plate. And here is the result, absolutely love, I'm going to put it aside and let's work with a stencil on the die cut piece. I did secure the stencil on top of one of the flowers and then I'm going to use 2 blending tools, the mini ones, one for the shades of green, one for the shades of pink. And for inking I'm going to use these 2 sets, Cherry Blossom and Tropical Forest. Now the stencils are very cleverly designed to make your life easy and it is going to help you create different shades of flowers by just using one set of inks. So first of all you align the stencil to cover up completely the bigger of the flowers and here I'm starting with a lighter color of my set which is Pink Diamond. I'm going to remove the stencil and you can go ahead and use the next layer. However, since I want to have an extra flower, now that I have my stencil here and the ink blending tool is dirty with that color, I'm going to quickly ink up one more flower on a separate piece of paper. This is going to give me the opportunity later on to cut out extra separate flowers so that I can make my bouquet fuller. And since I do have the stencil already on that paper, I'm going to move on to the next shade of color and this is Pinkalicious and I'm going to ink up the second solid flower. And by the way, I'm using the same mini blending brush for all the shades of these pink colors. I'm starting however from lighter to darker, so there is no need to clean up the brush in between. Now lay the stencil on top of the bouquet and it is really easy if you try to align those 2 little buds at the top. So again I'm still working with Pinkalicious, this is the second color on the set and you will find that on one of the flowers that we did previously, now we are adding shading, but for the 2 little buds as well as the second flower we are adding the first solid color. This is going to give some variation on the flower since one of them is going to look darker at the end. I'm going to lift the stencil so you can see the result and if you notice I like to use some low tack tape that I can reuse again and again to hold my stencil in place. However, I do that mainly for bigger areas. When I have to ink up a smaller one I just hold the stencil with my fingers. So here I am adding the 3rd layer of ink and that's Rubellite. And this Cherry Blossom set of inks by Altenew is probably my favorite and most used. I absolutely love this color combination. And I will continue with the next layer, again always following the guide at the packaging. And this time I'm using the darkest shade of the set which is called Razzleberry. And the darker shade when you are using layering stamps or layering stencils really makes a difference. It is what brings everything to life. And of course I do the same steps on the separate piece of paper where I am creating the extra 2 flowers. And then for the stems and the leaves there are only 2 layers, so I used only 2 shades which are Parrot, the lighter one, and then Olive for the shading. And just by inking through the openings with a couple of sets, you get a beautiful result. I also added the centers of the flowers by using espresso, just a darker shade of brown. And now I'm going to do my die cutting for the extra flowers. And the fun part about the extra flowers is that they don't give you a white border all around. Well, in my case, I didn't place the dies perfectly on top of the flowers, so I'm just going around with my blending tool to get rid of that white edge. And you can do that with a flower bouquet if you want to avoid that white border. After all, we don't have a black outline since we didn't use the stamp. You can place the extra flowers anywhere you like to make your bouquet look fuller. However, I decided to place them directly on top of their identical flowers. However, notice that I am offsetting them just a little bit so that you can see the petals underneath and the flower looks fuller. You can also fluff up the petals, just add them a little bit of a curve with your fingers. And my flower bouquet is ready. I'm going to work on my background now and I'm going to add some splashes. I'm using metallic watercolors and this is my favorite gold one. Just a few splashes here and there to make that background look more interesting. Those little touches of gold along with a 3D effect on the background really takes it to the next level. I'm also going to use an extra golden touch. This time I'm using the fine frames cover die and I do have a super fine frame. Before you cut it out, you can use double-sided tape so that you can just peel it off and use it as a sticker. But I find it easier to go with my Berli Art glue. This one has a super fine tip so that when I place it on top of my panel, I can easily manipulate those lines and make sure that they are nicely aligned and as straight as possible. I love those super fine borders. I think they give a touch of elegance on any card. Then I can place my bouquet on top and I love when I have elements going outside the frame. At the center of the flowers, I'm going to add a few gold gems just to add some extra sparkle there. And then all I have to do is to add a sentiment. A flower cut, as I always say, is perfect for any occasion. So in this case, I went with Just Because. This comes from the Essential Sentiment Strips die set. I cut it out from gold cardstock and I'm going to stick it on top of a white strip of cardstock. This way I can add some foam tape at the back and pop it on top of my card for an extra dimensional element. Now all I have to do is to stick this panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and here are some close-up photos on the card that I made for today. Don't forget that this is part of a video hop, so check out the video description below for the next stop of the video hop, as well as for all the info on the giveaways. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.